Windows function in Pandas. So what are Windows function? So Windows functions are functions where the input values are taken from a window of one or more rows in a series or table and calculation is performed over them. So if my requirement is if I have to calculate the mean over a period of 5 months for a sales data, then I would want to have a mean and then slide a window and then calculate the another mean. To just to understand it, let's go through some of the examples. So I have again taken the sample superstore data and I have again calculated the month and year from the date, and then I have created a pivot table for the sales data, and that's how the graph looks like. But if I look into my data, so this is how the data looks like. Now the objective is to run a window over the data and then calculate the mean. So let's say if I select a window period of 2 months, then I will select these two values, calculate the mean and take it as a output. Then sliding one more window and then 2 months would be data would be considered and calculated the mean. Similarly, I can have nth size of window. So I can have 3 months as a window size and values would be calculated. And similarly, I can have n number of such window size. So that's the whole requirement what we are going to try to do the calculation for. So if I just simply plot, so this is how my data looks like. And now let's look at the Windows function in Pandas. So Windows function in Pandas comes through rolling function. So in the rolling function, you provide what window you are looking for and then execute. And this gives you the object of that particular rolling function. So if I check, it's the object. Now using this object, I can calculate mean, median or minimum or the maximum on the selected rolling period. So for now, the 2 has been selected as my, or for our data, it's a 2 month. So if I calculate, it has calculated the mean over the period of 2 months and in a sliding approach. So if I just simply plot it now, so it looks little bit more smoothened than the previous actual values, right? So this gives me the clear trend that how exactly the sales of the particular month over month is being improved if I look into the mean values of it. Now similarly, I can have a minimum over the period of 2 months. So what was the minimum on those 2 months, and that would be my output now and defined on the given particular window. So if I just simply plot, I can just, now I have the minimum of the every 2 month combination over a sliding window. Similarly, I can calculate it based on other windows, and right now I've just plotted the graph separately using the subplots. So in Pandas, it's another functionality available to plot the different graphs separately. Now, what we explored so far is Windows functions where we can get the trends or patterns from the data, and mostly they are for time series. Even for a sensory data, like it has a high volume, and then there also we might need the rolling aggregations over a period of time or the sliding window. The another window approach available in Pandas is called expanding functions. So what happens with the expanding function? Let's take an example for it and try to figure out what happens. So I have just prepared a simple data to understand the output and observe the operations happening with the expanding function. So it gives me two particular criteria, one called center and another is called minimum period. So minimum period is like simply as like rolling window. But now let's explore by making center false and giving a minimum period of 1, and then I am calculating the sum on that expanding function. Now if I look at my output, what I can see is it has calculated the mean, or sorry, it has added the values based on, so 0, then summation would be 1, and then 3, and then 6. So I can see it's kind of a cumulative operation for now using the expanding function. Now let's check the mean. And now if I calculate the mean, it's kind of a mean over accumulated values. So 0 plus 1.5, I mean mean, then 2, 1 and 0. The mean is 1 because 2 plus 1 plus 0 divided by 3. Similarly, for the fourth position, 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 0 divided by 4 and hence 1.5. So similarly, if I add all, I get the mean as 4.5 for the overall. So this is how expanding function works. Now the another option is like center is equal to true. And when I do this, what happens if I have to understand, it would start from the center now. So now here it would take the value from here 4 and only one element, and that makes the mean 4. Then now these two elements 3 and 4 and their mean is 3.5. So 3 plus 4 divided by 2, 3.5. Similarly 4 plus 3 plus 2 divided by 3, 3. Similarly the rest of the half would start from here. So 4 and 5 giving the mean 4.5, 5, 4, 5, 6 giving the mean 5, 4, 5, 6, 7 giving the mean 5.5. So that's how expanding works, and it has this two keyword arguments, center and minimum period, works in the expanding function. Similarly, we have another window operation that's called EWM or exponential weighted functions. This particular functions actually works on a exponential functions which we have like half-life and some scientific operations. So if I have to explore EWM function, I have just simply taken same example and I have passed the object, so it will again create an object of EWM object or function object, and then I can simply ask for calculate the mean, and if I run it, the output right now I use com is equal to 0.5. Similarly, it has such other options like com, span, half-life. So if I just select half-life, it would calculate the half-life mean over the period of time. So how this particular functions are being calculated or the values. So if I give com center of mass, then this particular formula is being calculated to calculate the mean. If I select half-life, this particular formula is being used to calculate the mean. So that's how this scientific operations of exponential weighted function works in Pandas. This is all for the Windows function in Pandas. I hope you learned it. If you like my channel video, please consider subscribing to it, and have a great day. Thank you.